the Lord loved us so much that in our poverty, in our hell, I would come and deliver the broken, destroyed, messed up, poor, impoverished people I'm going to save.
Hey, Shalom Israel, Yahweh Bashimel Shadrach a Thug, Yahweh Shema'al a Thug, Bashimel Shadrach all the sisters, man. Listen, it's Captain 13,000, the Card of a Rhyme, checking in with the Israelite School of UPK, under Commander Jerry Hunt. Listen, man, this year's 52nd annual Passover. Hold on, I'm gonna say it one more time. This year's 52nd annual Passover under Commander Jerry Hunter under the ISUPK. Couldn't do it last year. Y'all already know the Lord had his foot on our oppressor's neck.
Here in New York City, there are roughly 1,000 cases a day. Those are numbers they haven't seen since May.
Can't do it in New York this year because the Lord still got his foot on our oppressor's neck.
New York, the center of the outbreak this spring, is now teetering on another deadly explosion of the virus.
But listen to me good. This year, 52nd annual Passover, April 24th, 2021. You understand? It's going to be in H-Town, baby.
It's going to be at the B&H Ranch, 14149 Player Street, Houston, Texas.
Y'all know what we do. Y'all know what we came to do. Huh? 2021, ISUPK, 52nd annual Passover. All the generals gonna be there. All the heavy hitters gonna be there. The daughters of Zion gonna step out with their beautiful long dresses, you understand? Strong on deck. That One West style music on deck. 52nd annual Passover.
B&H Ranch, 14149 Player Street, Houston, Texas.
Get with it to get lost, man.
Got it out the mud, straight up out the base. The world done made me crazy. The world done turned crazy.
You dealing with the men of war. We at war. I sided with the Lord, of course. On one accord. We ain't never stopping now. You running now. All my niggas go to ground. We go.
The oppressor has been teaching us lies ever since we have come in contact with him. His lies has destroyed blacks and Hispanics and Native Americans wherever we have been in contact with them. And this is going back since the beginning of time, since the beginning of our interaction with our oppressor. They have always hated us. They have always went out their way to destroy the Lord's chosen people, blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. I am not saying anything that's out of my mouth or my mind, my ideology. All of this is coming from the Bible, coming from the scripture. And every time we trust in our oppressor to do something for us, to we look for them to build us up, it's always us that are getting stabbed in the back. They show their true nature all the time. And we always overlook their true nature and try and find something good about their true nature. But whenever they show their true nature, we're destroyed. Read what you got.
The book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 12, verse 10. Never trust thine enemy.
Never trust thine enemy. This is scripture. The Most High says, never trust your enemy. There is a specific people that are enemies, that are the natural enemies. Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans right now, and have always been, our oppressor has always been our enemy. They have never been our friend. They have never been for us. They take and take and take from the best of us to further their life and leave us with squalor. The scripture says, never trust your enemy. They'll tell you who they are by their actions. They may say one thing and do a whole nother different thing. It says, never trust your enemy.
For like as iron rusteth.
Just like iron rusts, if you leave any piece of metal out in the rain and the elements, it's going to rust.
That's right.
If anybody know anything about vehicles, you get anything rust under the undercarriage or anywhere around your vehicle, it is rust. You might as well replace it because it's damaged beyond repair. You cannot fix that. It's rusting away. It's eating itself. The scripture says, just like rust, iron rust,
so is his wickedness.
So is our oppressor's wickedness. Just like the sun comes up, we should expect our oppressor to be wicked. We should expect our oppressor to look down and do things, go out of their way to harm us, individually and as a whole nation. You can tell right now by how the way they treat themselves. If they treat themselves, their own government that they love so much, the Capitol building where they hold their ideals sacred, if they going in there and defecating and their elected officials' offices, how will they treat you? How will they look at you and your issues? Just like their office they treated when they defecate in those offices, that's how they treat us. They're telling us how they treat their own sacred institutions. We are not sacred to them. How much worse can we expect them to treat us? Keep going.
Go. Verse 11. Though he humble himself and go crouching.
Though he humble himself and go crouching, though he talks slow and says smooth things, and he's coming to you like a friend, as a friend, just like he's doing this.
Yet take good heed and beware of him, and thou shalt be unto him as if thou hast wiped a looking glass.
Take good heed. Make sure you understand this, because once they coming together and they have their head low and they're talking sweet and kind words to you, wipe the looking glass like a film of dirt from the mirror or from the glass. You can see clearly, just like the scripture saying, it's telling you to observe their actions, not what their words are saying, because their words are sweet. The words are smooth. This is what the scripture is saying. Keep going.
And thou shalt know that his rust has not been altogether wiped away.
You should see that he's still dirty underneath, that he still does not have your intentions well in mind. He's only out for himself. He's saying one good thing with some honey or some cash in one hand, just like that stimulus check, and he has a knife in your back. He has a knife in your back. There is an ulterior motive as to anything that they do nice for us. If you can call it nice, if you can call it good, anything that they do for us is really a double cross that's going to be beneficial to them. It is never for us. You got anything else on that? Nah, give me Psalms 55 and 21. Psalms 55 and 21. This is saying, just like iron rusts, so is never trust your enemy. First of all, you should know who your enemy is. We've been teaching our people that our oppressor has been our enemy since day one. If it wasn't for our oppressor, our enemy, we would not be here right now. Our oppressor stole us from a land and put us in captivity and kept us in captivity. Just because the physical chains aren't on our arms or our shackles are on our feet, the chains are on our brains, are on our minds. We actually believe that this stinking nation is for us. We actually believe that we can turn the nation for us when this nation has never been for us. The Most High set up a nation for us. He set up a nation so that we should rule.
Israel.
We should rule not just in one land, but throughout the world. But we're beholden, most of our people are beholden to this nation that treats us like trash, that treats us like a receptacle that comes in a commode. This is the love that we give to the people, and this is how they treat us in return. Read what you got.
The book of Psalms, chapter 55, verse 21. The words of his mouth were smoother than butter,
The words of his mouth are smoother than butter. Even though they tell us smooth and nice things, things that we want to hear, things when Ice Cube went to the president and the presidential candidate, and he wanted to get something specifically for black people. The president gave him smooth words and told him he's going to give him everything that he wanted. This is exactly what he wanted to hear. Lo and behold, what's going on? What's going on? Nothing that he proposed is going to happen. It's going to come to pass. Now that the people that were running, Biden that was running, and he came to him and said, I'm not elected. Once I get elected, I can actually sit down and I'll have some teeth with that. He got elected. We haven't heard anything since. Although the words are smoother than butter,
but war was in his heart.
But war is in his heart. They'll tell us how smooth they are. They'll tell us things that we want to hear. They told the Capitol Police that they were coming here for a peaceful protest, knowing full and well that what they were going to do.
Right.
Knowing full and well that they were going to take the Capitol building.
Right.
Knowing full and well what their intentions were. They told this. They told the authorities, their own government, that they were just going to protest peacefully. Protest something that was legally binding. Protest something, a system that they all voted for. But when it came out that it wasn't their, it wasn't coming out to their liking, they went against it. They got violent. They showed their true face, and their true face is terrorism. It wasn't us. It wasn't us on that Capitol. It wasn't us storming a Capitol building. It wasn't us that was protesting the election, a democratic process which most people of this nation abide by. The same people that stormed that Capitol building believed in the system that allowed them to storm, to attempt a coup. They told their government that they were just going to protest peacefully. And because they told their government that they was going to protest peacefully, they had to mobilize 25,000 military armed troops. Because of that, they don't trust them. Now they don't trust them. There it says their words are smoother than butter.
His words were softer than oil, yet were they drawn swords.
It's all about war. It's all about warfare. To them, it's all about warfare. They don't want, they'll say one thing and do a totally different thing. Read that from the top, one more time.
Come. The words of his mouth were smoother than butter, but war was in his heart.
War is in his heart. He's telling you some smooth things so you can let your guard down. And once you let your guard down, he knows what he's going to do. He knows how he's going to attack you. He knows how he's going to try and take you out. His words are smoother than butter, but war?
But war was in his heart. His words were softer than oil, yet were they drawn swords.
All about war. It's all about war. Give me Matthew 5. Matthew 5 and 37. Matthew 5 and 37. Now they're telling them one thing. They're telling us one thing. We like to believe what they tell us. For the most part, if you tell us something, we like to believe what you tell us. That's just our way. That's just how we think. But when they actually tell us to do something opposite, contrary to what they're actually telling us, we should, and then we accept that, and then we listen to them again, we should not be surprised. And when they stab us in the back, once again, they have done this for 400 years. They told us one thing, and we believed it, and then they turn around and stabbed us in the back, time and time again. They came to the Capitol because they didn't like the outcome of the election. They wanted to stage a coup. They wanted those ballots to certify the president-elect. They wanted to take that process and throw it out the window. They violently came to the Capitol and committed violent acts, terroristic acts. They say they were coming here for one thing, but they knew all well what they were really coming here for.
If you love the ISUPK, stay in the loop. Go to Google Play and download the new user-friendly One West ISUPK app and get exclusive footage to our online classes and street speaking videos. Also, the Black Watch podcast, hosted by commanding General Yohanna, the leader of the Nation of Israel. It's real easy to stay in tune with the ISUPK and the information we're putting out. Just go to Google Play and type in One West UPK app and hit download. Let's get it in. Don't be left out.